This video is called Conversions, and it's about converting numbers from one type of unit to another type of unit. The general procedure for this is the following three steps. The first step is you start with the given number you need to convert. Secondly, you multiply by the appropriate conversion factors, which I'll talk about in a minute. And if you chose the conversion factors appropriately, then you'll be able to do step three, which is canceling the units to get the units you want. So a very important part of this is choosing the appropriate conversion factor. So what are conversion factors? They are ratios of things that are equal. A ratio is something that has something on the top and something on the bottom, and those things have to be equal. So let's say that we know that 1 foot, is equal to 12 inches. Okay, those are two things that are equal. To make it into a conversion factor, we put one of them on the top, 1 foot, the other one on the bottom. So we can say 1 foot per 12 inches. But we can do it the other way around. We can also say 12 inches per 1 foot. So those are two different possible conversion factors from the equivalency given here. All right, what's another example? 1 kilogram is equal to 2.205 pounds. So we can make two conversion factors by putting the two different parts on the top and the other ones on the bottom. There's one conversion factor, the other one is 2.205 pounds per 1 kilogram. All right, now let's use conversion factors to solve a problem. Let's convert from 3 pounds to kilograms. So obviously we're going to need one of these two conversion factors. All right, let's go back and follow the steps. The first step was start with a given number you need to convert. That would be 3 pounds. All right, and then what we do is we put that 3 pounds over 1. We can always do, right? Dividing by 1 doesn't change anything. But we do that to remember that 3 pounds is a value in the numerator. Then, conversion factor, we have a choice. This one or this one. The one we choose is the one that will cancel the units we don't want. We want to cancel pounds, so we're going to put pounds on the bottom. So 1 kilogram per 2.205 pounds. Then we can cancel the units that are on the top and the bottom, because pounds divided by pounds is equal to 1. And then we simply do the math. Our unit will be the units that are left, which is kilograms. And then we do the math. We do multiply all the numerators, 3 times 1, which is just 3, and the bottom, 1 times 2.205, which is just 2.205. So when you divide then 3 by 2.205, you get 1.36 kilograms. So that is our answer. All right, next, let's get a little more complicated. Sometimes one conversion isn't enough. You have to do more than one. So let's do an example of that. Let's say we need to convert 17,000 inches into kilometers, and we don't know the conversion directly from inches to kilometers. We don't know that equality, but we do know a bunch of things related to those units. We know that a kilometer is 1,000 meters, we know a meter is 100 centimeters, and we know the conversion from an inch to a centimeter. We can use all those to get to what we want. So let's start with 17,000, the number we were given. And always put the units in. Put it over 1 again to remind us it's a numerator. Now the first thing I'll do is convert the inches. The only thing I know about inches is that they are 2.54 centimeters. The inches goes on the bottom, 1 inch from here. 2.54 centimeters is the other part of that equality. So that goes on the top. Now our inches are canceled. Our answer, if we calculated it now, would be in centimeters. But we want kilometers, so we'll just keep going. We'll do the next equality, and we'll use this equivalency. Put centimeters on the bottom and the meters on the top. That's so that we can cancel centimeters. And our answer would now be in meters if we did all the multiplying and dividing. But we want kilometers. So we've got to do one more step. We use the final equivalency, put meters on the bottom to cancel, and the kilometers on the top. Okay, and then if we cancel those meters, we know our answer will be in kilograms. And then we do all the math. Multiply all the tops, multiply all the bottoms, divide the top by the bottom. And anytime you have ones, that doesn't change the number, so you can kind of ignore the ones. So it'll be 17,000 times 2.54 divided by 100 divided by 1,000. Your answer should be 0.43 kilograms. All right, here's a couple for you to try now that we've done this. So I would recommend that you try it by stopping the video and work these problems and then check your answers. All right, so the first one is a single step conversion. We have a given number, 2.2 miles. Over one. And we want to convert to kilometers. The conversion is given. Miles go on the bottom, 0.621 miles. The kilometers go on top. And when we do the math, we get 3.5 kilometers. Next example is a multi-step conversion, fluid ounces to liters. So let's start with the given number, 49 fluid ounces. And incidentally, it doesn't really matter what the units are. You don't have to be familiar with fluid ounces in order to do this problem. You just have to be able to follow the different conversions. So it doesn't matter if it was a unit you've never heard of or a unit you are very familiar with. You should still be able to do the conversion by using conversion factors. All right, fluid ounces. The only conversion we have here that involves fluid ounces is this one. So let's use it. Fluid ounces goes on the bottom. On the top is 1 quart. So fluid ounces cancel. We now have quarts. We want to get to liters. We don't have one directly to liters, so we use this one to get to gallons. The quarts go on the bottom, the gallon goes on top, then we cancel quarts. Our answer would be in gallons, but we'll keep going. We'll put gallons on the bottom and liters on the top, and then we do all the math. We don't forget to cancel. It'll be in liters, and the answer when you do all the math is 1.4. All right, let's get a little more complicated. What if there are powers in the units? For example, inches squared, meters squared, or centimeters cubed, or they can be cubed, they can be squared, they can be any kind of power. So let's do a conversion with that. All right, we still start with the given number and put it over one. All right, now, we know, let's say that we know the conversion from inches to centimeters, 2.54, and let's say that we know the conversion from centimeters to meters. All right, so we're going to have to do two steps here. Let's first do the inches, because that's what we have, and we put inches on the bottom again. 2.54 centimeters. All right, can we just put inches squared? Can we put centimeters squared? No, we can't do that. Okay, 2.54 is not the number of square centimeters in a square inch. It's only the number of centimeters in an inch. So if we want square inches, we have to square the entire conversion factor. That means the units and the numbers. All right, and we'll do that in a minute. First, we're going to do the other part of this conversion, which is going from centimeters to meters. So 100 centimeters to 1 meter And that centimeter is going to be squared. So this one has to be squared, which means we have to also square that entire factor. All right, what does this give us? 700 inches squared is already the way we need it. It's already square inches, so that doesn't change. But this one does. We have to square everything in the brackets. 2.54 squared, 6.45. Remember, the unit gets squared. 1 squared is just 1, and then inches squared. Then we square everything in the next bracket. 1 is squared, meters squared over 10,000, which is 100 squared, and centimeters squared. All right, so now we've set it all up. We can cancel inches, cancel centimeters, squared, of course. And our answer will be in meters squared. And the answer is 0.452. All right, and the final example I want to show you is, what if there's units on the bottom? So far, all the examples we have started with had only units on the top because we put them over 1. But in this case, we have units on the top and the bottom. So we put down the number you want to start with and convert, 1,200 kilograms per meter cubed, okay? And if it's per meter cubed, we can say it's per 1 meter cubed. So the first thing is to write it that way. And this is about the density of chalk. Density is always a mass per a volume, which this is. We want to convert it to mass in grams divided by the volume in milliliters. All right, so if we have units at the top and the bottom, and neither one of them is the one we want to end up with, we're going to have to do the top and the bottom separately. So let's start with the top. You don't need to start with the top. You could start with the bottom. It doesn't matter. But I'm going to start with the top, and I want grams. I have kilograms, and I know that conversion. So I'll put kilograms on the bottom. 1 kilogram per 1,000 grams. So now the top is what I want it to be. It's grams. The bottom I want to be in milliliters. And luckily I know that a milliliter is actually a cubic centimeter. So I want to get it to centimeters. All right, and the conversion from meters to centimeters is 1 to 100. And since meters is cubed here, I want this meter cubed, which means I have to cube the entire conversion factor. Finally, so that will cube, that will cancel my meters, because that one will be cubed. Finally, I don't want centimeters cubed on the bottom. I want milliliters, and it's a 1-to-1 correspondence. So we can say 1 cubic centimeter, that's a cube, is the same as 1 liter. So it's a 1-to-1. All right, and this particular term, the one we need to cube, remember you got to cube everything in it. So this term is really going to look like 1 meter cubed per, and you're going to cube the 100 centimeters cubed. All right, that's what it's going to look like. And so if you do all the math and you cancel all the units, I didn't do centimeters yet, you'll see that on top is grams and the bottom is milliliters, just like we wanted. So the units are grams per milliliter, and when you do the numbers, you'll get 1.5.